Vail has given me a very active, fun, enjoyable life. I think it's easy to take it for granted what we have here, how easy it is to be healthy. I moved to Vail because of that giant playground back there. Vail Mountain, one of the biggest resorts in North America. It's 100 yards away from me on a daily basis. Like, that's pretty wild to get to live and play here. I do love skiing with friends. However, I really love skiing alone on the resort because I do find just some time with myself. The sound of skiing alone is pretty incredible too. You know, whether it's a hard packed day, ripping groomers, or a powder day and just hearing that, whoosh, it's pretty cool. Oh, my favorite thing about Vail are all the dogs, of course. Bring your dogs to me, I need to see them. I mean, honestly though, like, my favorite thing about Vail is the community. We do have a strong community, and finding the people that you can share fun moments with, that's what we have here. I don't think I've ever walked into Two Arrows and not laughed. There's always such an amazing vibe there that if you are having a bad day, you're gonna walk out of there with a smile on your face, for sure. There's a lot of love here. I'm very lucky to have such a strong group of people around me all the time. Was lucky enough to find my way with Craniology to take over the store and run our Beaver Creek location as well. My passion is definitely making sure that our guests are taken care of and they have the best time that they can and enjoy the views that we get to see every day. Plenty of restaurants in Vail. Getting out, having dinner, drinks with friends, eating some delicious food. That's what it's about. The amount of fun things to do that are pretty much free in town, especially in the winter. Like, we had the whole concert series this past winter. Go watch some free live music and enjoy dancing with everybody else in town. I love being able to do fun activities walking out that door.
I love to ski. I love that sense of motion and speed and all that I had to offer, and I always wanted to get better at it because I saw people that would do really well. The carving on a snowboard, or not in the bumps. Bumps was a wild bucking bronco ride, you know, but carving was a symphony. First experience of a snowboard was they put me on the racing carving board, and I just got into it, and it took me another 5 years probably just to get the basics of it. And it was so exciting, just incredible experience, just flowing. Taking a quick trip on the bus and then getting to my locker, and it's easily accessible. And then the most exciting part of being here in Vail is the winter for me. I get to get my excitement on the mountain. Like any sport, you get attached to it and it becomes exhilarating. Sometimes I like to go over to the Gorsuch coffee shop and grab a cup of coffee, or especially more so at the end of the day, I enjoy my coffee. Great little places to enjoy in town here in Vail and the environment. I have high respects for the lifties. Acknowledging their presence here wasn't just as part of the machinery, but they were real people. It takes a lot of patience for having us be on the mountain having fun, and they have all this machinery and noise, and they have to be here and do all this stuff and take responsibility for all that. I keep my equipment up to 100% race quality all the time. A couple guys I met over at Christie Sports, I really like what they do, and I can tell them what my degrees are and what I want, and the end result is the board comes back and it's just like brand new. It's just awesome. It's been about 25 years I've been riding my carving board, and there's a certain motion that can flow, and you put the motion and momentum together, and all of a sudden, it's just amazing what happens. Just, it's an incredible feeling, so I love it. Joe is short for my real name, and the Fog is Fast Old Guy, F-O-G, and I love it. People call me Fog or whatever they want to. I understand. Just don't call me late for dinner, that's all.